Hello, I'm Fred Thompson. I'm one of the countless number of Americans who know firsthand that in this country, a person may be born into modest circumstances, but that he comes into the world blessed in ways that have been unimaginable to the vast majority of people who have ever lived. We're born with the birthright of freedom and opportunity. Free to make our own choices about the important things in our life, and the opportunity to fulfill our God-given potential. The greatest fear that I have for my country is that our government now has us on a different path. Instead of freedom and opportunity, it's one of debt, dependence, division, and decline, a path that will weaken our country and sap the vitality of the American people. We have moved from an era of balanced budgets to a time of debt as large as our entire economy and of lost credit ratings. In 2001, when I was chairman of the Senate Governmental Affairs Committee, I released a report that we call Government on the Brink, in which I laid out the extent to which our government was bloated, growing, wasteful, subject to massive fraud, and basically out of control. A decade later, it's worse. Today, federal bureaucrats think they can tell a family where they can build their home and a business where it can locate. I believe that how one views the condition and trajectory of our country determines how one views the strengths of our presidential candidates. For me, I believe that we're at a tipping point, one from which we may not return. To avoid these disastrous consequences, our country needs leadership that is fearless and confident, a candidate who can give voice to the concerns and frustrations of the American people. Someone who understands and will never apologize for American exceptionalism. We don't need to just manage the way Washington works. We need to fundamentally change Washington. It would be a major setback for our party and our country if we elect a president who is not up to that challenge. We need someone who has the courage and ability to communicate the truth to the American people. Someone who will explain the hard choices that we must make if we're to give our children and grandchildren the same opportunities our forefathers bestowed on us and avoid the fate that other great nations have suffered throughout history. I believe that person is Newt Gingrich, and that's why I strongly support him. I came to Washington in 1995, in part as a result of the political revolution that Newt conceived and led. Over the next few years, we were able to balance the budget, pass welfare reform, and begin to rebuild a weakened military. So we know it can be done. Unfortunately, some on our side lost their way. We became divided and fell into recriminations and finger-pointing. Sometimes success is a difficult thing to handle. I believe that most of us have learned from our mistakes and are now focused on the future. And the dangers and opportunities that lie ahead for our country. President Obama's strategy is simple. Avoid the hard realities his failed policies have created over the past 3 years. Divide the country, pander to and organize his various constituencies, and eke out another victory. I believe he fails to see what so much of the political establishment and the Washington insiders on both sides of the aisle fail to see, that these past few years have changed our people. And our country. People in America don't want to be told what to do, and they certainly can't be told what to think. They see for themselves what's happening in Europe with Greece and Spain and the lot, and do not want it happening on our shores. And they're spontaneously organizing in towns all across America. They realize that on our present course, we may not recognize our country in a few years. They're waiting to be inspired. And energized to a cause that will conserve those first principles that made us the envy of the world. Now, this cause can't be led by glossy flip charts, processing data, or reams of talking points poll-tested by a room full of consultants. It must be led by someone who can forcefully make our basic case for the economy. For example, how lower taxes benefit all Americans and can raise revenue for the legitimate and limited functions of the federal government. Someone who is able to articulate the message of growth, free enterprise, and freedom. Someone who knows that bold ideas have preceded every major achievement of mankind, including the United States of America. I believe that Newt Gingrich is that person. If you agree, please join Newt and me in this effort to renew America's exceptionalism. Go to newt.org, show your support. Thank you.